Hello, welcome to my fourth tutorial about Torino, which is a project I'm using to speak about GitHub, Azure, my web framework named BlackSheep for Python, and about running Python web applications in Azure. In this tutorial, I will go through a slightly more advanced topic, that is configuring an identity provider to issue access tokens for a single page application, where the access tokens will be used to connect to an API, which of course will validate those access tokens. In this case, the identity provider is Azure Active Directory, but the same principles can be applied to Auth0 and Okta, for example. So let me start from a schema. Earlier, we ran the single page application without any authentication. What we want to achieve is that the single page application will redirect unauthenticated users to the identity provider sign-in page. And after sign-in, the identity provider will give an ID token and an access token to the SPI. The SPI will connect to the API server we are building with Python using an access token. So the identity provider in this case is Azure Active Directory, and it needs to know about these two applications. So we will need to create two so-called app registrations in Active Directory. And the app registrations will be configured in such a way that the SPA can request access tokens for the API. So let's see together how this is done in practice. We'll go back to the Azure portal, to my directory I'm using for these tutorials. And then we'll go to Azure Active Directory. I will go under App Registrations, and I will start by creating an app registration for the API part. Torino Tutorial API. I will leave selected accounts in this organizational directory only, meaning that users won't be able to do sign up, so to create a new account. Only users who will be invited by me will be able to sign in for the application. I don't need to configure any platform for the API because the API won't provide interactive sign-in. Now, what I need to do when I create the app registration for the API, I need to expose an API. So we go to expose an API and I will click on add a scope. I leave the ID as the Active Directory, Azure Active Directory is providing. And in this case, the examples files read is a good one because Torino is an application about adding virtual file systems and files. So I will select admins and users, so users can also consent to the scope. And I click add a scope. Now, by default, the application will request consent, user's consent the first time the user logs in. But if you want to disable this, you can later use a feature to remove this request. But now let's create an app registration for the single page application. I will go back to app registrations, new registration. And this time we create a Torino Tutorial SPA. And in this case, for platform, I will select a single page application and I will configure the URL under which my Webpack server is serving on my localhost. HTTP localhost 3000 because it is running on port 3000. See, right now it is running without authentication because I didn't configure it yet. Sorry. So click register. Now that I have a pre-registration for the single page application, I will go under API permissions, because I need to configure this app registration in such a way that it can request access tokens for the API I just created earlier. So we'll go to API permissions, add a permission. I will need to select APIs my organization uses, and Torino tutorial API. And I will select this scope, add permissions. As I mentioned, there is a feature that lets disable the consent request for the users who are signing in for the first time. And I will use it in this case. I will click here, grant admin consent for default. Yes. Now, what we need to do? We need to configure the API in such a way that it will validate the JWT access tokens, and to configure the SPA in such a way that will redirect the user to the right place when they are not authenticated. So let's start from the API part. We'll go back to the Torino tutorial API. I will go to the Exposen API, and I will copy the application ID URI. Let me copy it this way, because sometimes it doesn't work. Copy. I go back to the settings YAML file of my web server, and I will configure out audience. This one, we get this example here. And for issuer, I will configure this domain with the ID of my tenant. You can find the ID of the tenant on the Azure portal. Under overview, you get it here. Directory tenant ID, it is this one. In my case, it's already in the example, so I will simply copy this line here. The source code of my Python web application in Torino is configured to automatically enable JWT Bearer authentication on application start when you have these two lines configured in the settings of the application. And this is happening under app, out. You can see here, configure out. It is checking if settings are configured of the authentication. It is enabling JWT Bearer authentication and authorization, which by default will require an authenticated user. I'm also adding some logic to require certain action for certain action to have a specific role, but I will speak about this later. Please know that I wrote everything here. I'm the author of the libraries that handles also the authentication of the JWT Bearer authentication, at least at the high-level API. So now when I restart the server, it will request access token. Python server, it won't show anymore that authentication is disabled. Let's also configure the single page application to use authentication. So I will go to the settings.js file, and I will need to configure API scope, client ID, and client authority. The API scope is the scope we just created earlier for the API. Let's see if it worked. The copy to clipboard. Yes. Then the client ID will be the client ID of the single page application app registration. So I will go back to the Torino tutorial SPA. And I will copy the application client ID there. And for client authority, I will need something like this. Login Microsoft.com with a tenant ID. In my case, either Roberto Privato on Microsoft or the global and unique identifier would work. So I will copy the globally unique identifier, the tenant ID. Now It should work. Yes, you can see already the Webpack server, development server through hot reload. It refreshed my page because now it requires an authenticated user. When I click login, sign in, it should work. I should be redirected to the sign in page of my tenant. And single sign-on kicked in, so I am logged in. It knows that I'm robertoprevato@gmail.com. And it says that I don't have any specific role. This is something, of course, I designed in the in Torino. Now, if I go here, it loads the album, but in this case, it is using an access token for the API. So if I open the developer tools and I inspect the network traffic for this web request, I will see that it includes a request header authorization bearer. And this access token is issued for the API. Copy. I can go to a website like jwt.ms, which allows me to inspect this token. So I will paste it here. And right, in this case, it's not this is not something you can parse, sorry, because it is truncated. It's not shown entirely. So let me go to raw. I will copy it entirely, and then it will work. This depends on Firefox, because if you go to other browsers, they don't truncate this way the request headers. I'm even having problem copying it. Let me see if it works. Yes. And you can see now the information, the audience of the token was this one. The issuer was this one. This information is validated by the code in BlackSheep because it has built-in support for JWT Bearer authentication. And the headers are saying that the token is signed using the asymmetric algorithm. And the key ID is this one. So what happens, the BlackSheep server in Python is fetching the OpenAPI configuration from the Azure Active Directory. It gets the list of JWT case. So it gets the public numbers, the public component of these keys used to create, to sign and to verify JWT tokens. And it is validating them in memory. I wrote a nice article a long time ago on this topic. So the last thing I want to show is that the Python web server is also configured to require some specific roles in some cases. So it has the notion of an admin role, which can create new albums and upload files. How this is achieved? You can configure application roles in the API. So if we go back to the Torino tutorial API, we can go under app roles and configure app roles. These app roles will be included as roles claims in the JWT tokens issued for the user once the user is assigned with that role. So let's see together how to do it by hand. However, also please know that the repository contains a script, a bash script, that uses the Azure CLI to create these app registrations using a manifest file which contains the roles definition, administrators and users. But now for this tutorial, I want to show you how to configure it by hand. So we go here, we do create app role, and I write administrators, users. For value, I will put admin in capital letters because this is what is validated by Torino. So if I go back to server out, you will see here role requirement admin. So this must match the value of the application role. And admins do. I want to enable this application role. So I click apply. Once the role is assigned to the application, I can go under Azure Active Directory, Enterprise Applications. I will select the Torino Tutorial API. And here I can assign the role to users. So I go to users and groups. I can assign the role to myself. You see, it is not displaying yet the admin because I just created it. So let me try to refresh. We see now the select role administrators. I will find myself. And click assign. Now, when I repeat login, my JWT Bearer token will contain also the roles claim with the admin value. So this is everything for this tutorial. I showed how to create app registrations on Azure Active Directory, how to enable the authentication in the Torino. You can inspect the read the source code of the UI part to see how MSL.js is used to implement authentication. And I explained how to use it in also in my web framework, BlackSheep. So thank you for listening and have a nice day.